find that it's facilitating the true amateur in art. So we encourage people to bring their art, their style, and to add to this wonderful cacophony of creativity that we have here at Lovebird.
And that's to reimagine, if the Roman Empire never ended, what would have become of its architecture?
Advice in general is participate. It's what makes you burn. And giving back makes it all that much more.
You got invited back again this year to bring it back as the temple.
How long did it take you to build it?
I lost count at 3,500 hours.
I developed this concept about 10 years ago, playing around in my backyard with some leftover art pieces.
We're here to present Kunkan's portal and the electric dandelions. This is our first year at Love Burn, and we're super excited to be here.
Burns are a temporary city that is built in a week, nearly entirely from attendees, then is broken down the following week in such a way that you should never know we were there in the first place.
Cinderella-inspired, I Dream of Genie interior, and it was all custom laser cut and then individually welded together.
The intersection between Islamic and Christian architecture.
We started small as a tiny dome. Now it's a system of about 10,000 pieces all put together.
I'm here with a crew of about 5 or 6 people. The star represents the soul of the body, and Kukulkan is the transporter of that soul.
Lovebird is all about the community, about the energy. And about that great sense of play.
Vehicle was the biggest challenge to take on, but worth every part of it.
Where we come back to every year, we all get together beneath the flames, burn all night while we do.
Arranged around the sphere and then 4 subwoofers underneath it to give a full surround sound experience.
people all around. You know, we just wanted to experience the love. Love Burn is what it is. People just wanting to give each other love.
All of the Burn is about love. It always has been.
That's why I come.
Oh, you gotta get in there now. Go ahead, dig your finger in.
That's gonna hurt somebody.
We discovered the fire inversion.
12 principles, that there were 10. And the 12th one is don't be a dick.
Almost saw the flyboard show with the flamethrowers, but as we were walking back, we saw a huge explosion in the air, and we were like, fuck, we missed it.
What we call the porthole of fire, we almost got put on the map as the butthole of fire, and these would be the pink eye towers, but unfortunately they caught it.
Oh, I had avocado toast this morning.
Yeah?
Yep.